Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. So this is Atlas Fallen, Reign of Sand, a game that got released a couple of months ago. It got pretty good reviews, not great, but not so bad. So it's one of these action kind of games, new IP, totally new IP. So it did pretty well when it comes to reviews, like I said. Now, this game just got added to Game Pass yesterday, I think. It's available on both Xbox and PC Game Pass, so you can give it a try. It's also available on PlayStation. You can buy it there if you want. Today I'm going to be checking this game on Xbox Series X. We'll be looking at this game's graphics, performance, gameplay, all that kind of stuff, as always. So without any further ado, let's actually press that A button to start. I did play this game for a few minutes just to give it a try, just to check if it actually works. But before we get into the gameplay, let's check settings, because there's some settings there. You can choose between performance and quality mode. However, I can tell you straight away, at least at the very beginning of the game, the performance mode looks pretty good, especially that you can use the Super Resolution 2 upscaling technology, and the game looks really, really good, right, when it comes to image quality and stuff. So let's leave it at that. Yeah, performance, AMD, fidelity, super resolution set. By the way, I did disable chromatic aberration because I don't like it. But hey, it's up to you. Also, I did reduce motion blur because, yeah, I mean, if a game is a 60 FPS game, no need for that. Right, so let's start the game and see what it's all about. Let's play on normal. This is literally the very beginning of the game. As you can see, the loading speeds are very, very quick.
The life source of our world sleeps in the sands.
You know what? I will skip cutscenes because you are not here to watch cutscenes. So let's actually get to the meat and potatoes.
Where am I?
And image quality is really good. It's very sharp. I don't necessarily see any artifacts or anything like that. And so that's very good news. I'm not sure what engine this game is using. Yeah, I don't want to invert the camera. Okay. So yeah. There you go. As you can see, there's a lot of stuff going on over here. A lot of graphics effects and stuff, a lot of explosions and transparencies and whatever, right? Fog, fire, and it's stable 60 frames per second. I mean, for the most part, right? And there might be some stutters, slight stutters here and there, nothing major. As you can see, this reminds me of God of War a little bit at the very beginning. You know, you've got this axe and you slash enemies and stuff. It's actually quite satisfying. I'm not sure if you noticed, there was a little bit of a stutter there. Nothing major, but generally speaking, performance is pretty good. So you can run. Yeah, you've got all these effects and everything going on. And the game is actually pretty stable. I'm actually pretty surprised that the game is actually pretty sharp, because like I said, AMD FSR 2 even sometimes introduces artifacting and that kind of stuff, but I don't really see that, at least not here initially, right? But the first impression is, and that's what this video is really all about, the first impression is actually pretty good. Yeah, frame rate looks good, it's pretty smooth. Oh, there was a little bit of stutter there, so there you go. So it's not like super, super ultra smooth, but it's smooth for the most part, so...
Once again, that voice.
Unless you Digital Foundry, you probably won't be bothered with that as much. There we go. There's more of them now. Yeah, it's kind of cool that at least in this particular battle scene you've got this huge hammer, it's an axe, and you can slay enemies like from the distance too. So you've got
there's more of them. This place.
Okay, we got some superpowers. Okay, let's do it. Bam. Yeah, even with these huge explosions and that kind of stuff, I don't necessarily see any frame rate drops. And there is a little bit of a pop-up, if you notice, like if you look at like in front of the character. You can see some of the like bushes popping up and disappearing here and there, but it's nothing major. Although, you know, I remember when this generation was first introduced that we would not get that at all. We would not get loading times and all that kind of marketing speech. And but generally speaking, oh shit. I don't think we've got much to complain about. Sure, PCs are more powerful, better. I mean, but you have to pay more, I guess, too. So, and another little bit of. I think these are traversal starters, like when they load the new thing. So. Who are you? Alright, so who are you? That's why they asked. I am somebody. Okay, so I don't really. I mean, you can randomize, sure, but you know what? I'll just go with this guy, I guess. Maybe this one? No, not really. This guy? No. An old guy? I'm not that old. Let's just go with this one, right? You can choose voice.
Knowledge for knowledge.
The world.
Oh, that's
change. One way.
You raised me to see the world differently.
Okay, let's just
to challenge what I knew.
So if you are following into customizing your characters and stuff, you can do it. I'll just skip it.
Her voice. Hey.
Okay.
The wraiths attacked. You were struck down. We managed to get you back here.
And the others?
Many of us were lost. We recovered the bodies, but Reeve.
Yeah, graphics actually is pretty good. And this is like a smaller studio.
They're still out there.
Who made that game? Was it Deck 13? Yes.
And perhaps somebody else.
Then we must go.
Yeah, let's just skip that.
Indeed. In the upper camp. For Thelos' sake, be careful.
Okay, so now there is a little bit of a open world to that game, I guess.
By Thelos.
You can explore things. What was that?
I was surprised when our caravan changed route. Even more so when I observed that it was on the Queen's orders.
In the middle of the day.
I would have warned them about this cursed territory.
So graphics-wise,
the captain has his eye on me.
It's not Hellblade, that's for sure.
Careful not to attract attention.
But it looks pretty good.
Born and unnamed.
Okay, I'm noticing some frame rate drops here and there, unfortunately. So that's
my mission to teach
a bit of a bummer.
People hope.
Not sure if that's a GPU issue or what. You know what? Let's actually check if we can change settings here. Yeah, let's turn off FSR and see how that game looks. You know, it still looks pretty good.
The sands are watching us.
The storm is taunting us.
Yeah, but there seems to be a more of a more issues, performance issues. So let's actually turn that on again. Yeah, I don't really see much of a difference, to be honest with you. So I'm not sure what that was. Yeah, that's all about.
Not water with the trace of food. Just a pinch of salt.
Maybe you have to restart the game or something. Who knows? So as you can see, exploration is actually a thing over here.
Hey, you two, get moving!
First time I see a rig close up.
It's not like super smooth 60 frames per second, at least here in the camp. So I'm guessing it must have something to do with the CPU, because the previous section was actually pretty packed with graphics effects and everything, and it was pretty smooth. So I guess it's more about like number of objects and PCs and stuff, but you will notice these stutters just like occasionally. It's not like it's chattery all the time. Oh, there we go. There was a little bit of stutter here, so not sure what's that all about. Yeah, but looks like, generally speaking, the game is pretty smooth. There's Captain over here.
The unnamed are unsafe.
And obviously,
they dispute the new route, talk amongst themselves. I must admit my own doubts over the Queen's orders.
So there's also a quality mode over here. So let's switch it to quality mode. Oh, game needs to restart. Okay, I'll skip it. Not going to be restarting it. The game is pretty sharp. So like quality mode, I mean the performance mode offers very sharp image quality. So I don't even see why would you want to switch to quality mode, which is 30 frames per second. Maybe the graphics is a little bit better. You know what, let's just actually switch it and quickly and see if it actually quality mode. Apply. Okay, so apply. All right, so let's
will spell our doom.
Let's actually restart it. Yeah, let's restart it and see how that goes. Okay, start, continue. Continue. Yeah, it's 30 frames per second, and to be honest with you, I don't really see much of a difference when it comes to graphics. So I really don't understand why would you want to use quality mode. Like, makes no sense. Like, I don't really... I mean, you know, Digital Foundry probably will tell you that there's like few pixels more in quality mode, but like, playing the game, you don't even notice that much. So just stick to performance mode, select FSR2, and you'll be good, because you will be getting both good graphics, high image quality, and 60 frames per second for the most part. But here is just 30 frames per second, and it's not that great, like, you know. So anyway, guys, listen, that's the video. I hope you enjoyed it. Let me know in the comment section below what you think about it, and are you planning to play this game? Have you played this game? Let me know in the comment section below, and I'll see you in the next one. Take care.